After successfully deploying your Veeam Backup for AWS appliance, the next crucial step is to set it up so you can start protecting your workloads on AWS. Hi, I'm Julia with Veeam, and today we'll be diving into the initial configuration of Veeam Backup for AWS. Let's go! Right-click here on your appliance, and then open console. The web browser may display a warning notifying that the connection is untrusted, but this is normal and you can just go ahead and accept it. Click on Continue. Or you can also replace the TLS certificate that is currently used to secure traffic between the browser and the backup appliance with a trusted TLS certificate. This is the interface you're going to see when you first log in into Veeam Backup for AWS. To start setting up your backup environment, click on this configuration button on the top right. It will take you to the configuration wizard, which will walk you through the entire configuration process step by step. The first step would be add an AWS IAM role to our appliance, but since we've deployed it through Veeam Backup and Replication, it's been done already. We've also created and added a backup repository to our Veeam Backup for AWS appliance, so we don't need to do that either. The only thing we have to do is configure the workers. These workers are temporary EC2 instances that will perform the backups. They are spun up whenever they are needed and shut down when the job is done, which is fantastic for cost optimization as you only pay for the compute resources when you need them. Let's start by clicking Add. And here we choose the AWS region for which we want to configure network settings. We need one worker per region where we have instances to protect. I'm going to pick North Virginia. Then we choose an availability zone. Click Next. Now we select a VPC to which we want to connect the worker instance. Then a subnet and a security group. Click Next. Finally, we can see a summary of our settings. And if you want to turn on auto IP assignment to use a private network, you can go to our user guide and read our documentation. Click Finish. Now, if we go back to the wizard, we see that we've successfully completed the initial configuration steps and we can start creating our first policy to protect our AWS workloads. And there you have it! Configuring your Veeam Backup for AWS appliance is a breeze. Now you're all set to start creating backup job policies. In our upcoming videos, we'll delve into everything you need to know to start protecting your workloads on AWS effectively. If you have any comments or questions, feel free to drop them in the area below. And don't forget to subscribe so you can stay updated with all our content releases. Thank you for watching!